Coast of M963. Welcome back, Carlos. I haven't spoken to you for a couple of weeks. Carlos Camacho, our psychologist.
Hello, Deb.
Good to see you as always.
Yeah, it's been a while, hasn't it?
It has been. And last week, or 2 weeks ago, I think now, maybe three, we spoke about Aristotle, and we're following up on that today. Much more to speak about that wonderful man, isn't there?
Yes, oh, we could go all year with Aristotle because he's left us so much knowledge on so many areas. But last week, or 3 weeks ago, last time we spoke, we talked a little bit about his theory of the mean, the middle, where he thought a certain type of moderation is important in life.
And the happiness.
Yes, that's right. And it sounds right, doesn't it?
It does.
It does sound. It's so simple, but yet he wrote it down. We didn't.
Yeah, that's right.
And therefore, it influenced our thought. But I think a lot of people stopped me and actually sent me emails wanting to expand on that. So that was
fantastic.
It's great that people want to know about it because it can be useful for our practical life.
In daily lives here in this day and age.
That's right.
Yeah, he's all about pleasure and friendship, isn't he?
Well, yes. It's all about measuring your desires. And he actually used a wonderful word that we don't use it for that these days, but he used the word incontinence.
We use it in different ways, don't we?
We use it in a physical way when you can't control your bodily functions.
Yes.
But incontinence, traditionally, all those years ago, 2,500 years ago, comes from a Greek word, and it's used to not be able to control your psychological desires.
Oh, that makes sense, doesn't it?
And he thought that the person who is incontinent and gives in to their desires all the time can never be truly happy.
That's right. So what's the word for in the middle? Continent?
The person that's continent can regulate their passions, their desires, and it's important not only for themselves, because Aristotle felt that the extremes, when you cross to an extreme or you fall into your desires, you're actually going out of your own territory and stepping on other people's space.
Yes.
Isn't that incredible?
It is incredible. Mm. What a genius.
All extremes, as we know, in politics, in religion, in philosophy, in many areas of life, seem to be a little bit difficult for us to comprehend, not only because of the person's extreme thoughts, but because it seems to invade our own space. So I think Aristotle was right there.
Yes, very good. And he really believed in friendships being very important to happiness as well, didn't he?
Yes, he did. And he had three types of friendship. Mm-hmm. And I think he's hit it on the mark again. He felt that there's one type of friendship which is utilitarian, which means that both get something out of it.
Okay.
Almost like a business transaction.
Yes, you're in it for something.
Yeah, that's right. And that's fine. We don't talk about it, but we both get what we want.
Yep.
And the second one is the friendship of pleasure, which means that you do certain activities with that person that provides pleasure to both of you. Of course, there's a physical pleasure, but it could be something like going to the footy or that person that you ring up when you want to go clubbing or whatever it may be, and you share a certain activity that give you both pleasure. And the third and the most important one was the friendship of goodness.
Goodness, okay. And how do you explain that one a bit?
He felt that you meet people occasionally in your life, and he had a wonderful way of explaining it, that you share a soul with.
Yes.
Isn't that wonderful?
Beautiful. That's the perfect love, isn't it?
It's beautiful. And it is true, when you find that person in your life that's of true friends, unconditional, it's almost like you're sharing your soul. And in today's world, you could say you're sharing the mind, because you think so alike, and you don't necessarily have to be the same type of person, but in the most important things of life, you do share a certain type of knowledge and love for certain things, and it's almost like you're sharing that soul.
Yeah, because you actually start each other's sentences, don't you, or finish them when you're that close.
It's just, and we call it, we say chemistry today too, don't we?
Yes.
And I think Aristotle, what he wanted to say was that a lot of people in our lives come and go, but there's going to be the occasional person that for some reason we click, and the best way of putting it is to be able to share that soul together throughout our journey. And it's a wonderful way of putting it, I think.
Sure is. It's beautiful. And it's the love for yourself as well, isn't it?
Exactly. Aristotle did say that. And usually he felt that the person that is capable of finding goodness in friendship is usually someone that is self-aware, but also has a certain independence. And it's almost a contradiction, because that other person that you find doesn't really need someone else. But yet, when you find that person and you're both well, you're both quite independent,
yes,
and not in need of things to, yes, make you happy, you click.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, you add
to the relationship.
That's right.
To each other.
Exactly, yeah.
And talking about friendship, we were just chatting off air about Greg Inglis and the troubles he's going through at the moment with depression after finishing his career. Because I coached him at high school when he was a young boy, and he started from childhood aiming towards that goal of playing football for Australia.
Yep.
And that means, you know, he had to going out with the mates while he was growing up,
sure,
you know, being sidetracked and all of that stuff. So
yes,
friendship's very important, isn't it, to him at the moment?
It is. And and looking at it in the way Aristotle would look, yes, at it, he really now he requires the friendships of goodness, because something like footy or anything else that someone does from very young, it becomes an identity. Once that's, yes, gone, it's almost like a piece
of... Who am
that.
I?
That's right.
Yeah.
And it's important for someone like Greg Inglis to understand that that's only one part of, yes, who we are. And it served a wonderful part in his life, because it's given him so much,
yes,
this sport. But it, and you're right, because he's given up so much in his youth,
yes,
for it,
yes,
it felt like he's given all this. Sure, he's had some good stuff back, but now what do I do? It's,
yes,
important now to be supported by the true friends, not the utilitarian friends or the ones of pleasure.
Okay.
I'm sure we all have many of those.
Yes.
And when you play in a team, there's many utilitarian friends, because you need them. They're, mm-hmm, practical. They're there. But you need to find the friends of goodness in order to get through this,
yes,
part. And I remember when Ian Thorpe, mm-hmm, he retired at a very young age.
Yes.
And he said, "I'm just tired of following a black line." And that was so important. I thought, wow, for a young man to say that, get in the pool and just swim, and just all he sees is a black line.
All the time.
And for us outside, again, what are you talking about? But,
yeah,
you've won gold medals and that. But the human being requires other things.
Pleasure. Requires
to be able to have, I think, like Aristotle said, that balance somewhere in the middle is about right. When you're training and doing one thing all your life,
yeah,
that's an extreme as well.
Great
and
way
that's,
to relate it, Carlos.
Yeah, you can't be happy. You need to find the mean. And I think GI is a good time for him to do that.
Yes. Well, great. I looked at a quote here from Aristotle, and I think it relates to that. Pleasure in the job puts perfection in the work, and that's what these people, Greg Inglis and Ian Thorpe, have
that's
done,
right,
all their lives.
Exactly. And it's sure they do that one thing great, and we know them for it, but it's only a few minutes in the day that we see them perform quite well. Then there's 24 hours, 7 days a week that person has to live with themselves.
That's right.
They have to find that balance in order to be truly happy.
Well, thank you for coming in, Carlos. Great topic, as always.
Thank
Carlos
you.
Camacho, psychologist here at Coast FM. You chose a great song to end our little chat today.
End the episode on Aristotle, Stuck in the Middle with you.
Steeler's Wheel on Coast FM at 11:30.
I fall off my chair, and I'm wondering how I'll get down the stairs. Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right. Here I am, stuck in the middle with you. Yes, I'm stuck in the middle with you.